what's up guys and welcome back to 40 Runs. Now if this is your first time at 40 Runs, I want you to smash that pink button down there that says subscribe on it. Go to our Facebook page and join the 40 Runs running community and check out the description. There's loads of cool things down there. Right, this week we've got the 361 Pacer ST, so let's get stuck in. Right guys, so here is the 361 Pacer ST. First up, a disclaimer, I was sent this shoe by 361. I'm not being paid by 361 to make this video. They've got no control over the video, all the views are my own, but I just wanted to let you know before we got stuck in. Right, so the Pacer ST, which is their kind of racier shoe, their up-tempo shoe. If you've not seen the videos, I've already reviewed the Spire 4, which is your kind of long run cushion shoe. You've got the Meraki shoe, which is like your daily trainer, your everyday trainer. And then you've got this, which is like the up-tempo Pacer shoe. I wouldn't call it an out-and-out race shoe. I don't think that's what it's pitched at. It's nice and light, 7.5 ounces, which is awesome. It's got a 9mm drop. In the midsole, you've got the quick foam and then you've got the quick spring plus. There's also a propulsion plate even at the front of the shoe, which is pretty awesome. So you get that kind of nice snappy feel as you roll over. I would say straight away, as a heel striker, there's not much cushioning at the back. Now that's me having a bad running form. But what I would say is if you are sort of more towards the front of your strike when you land, this will suit you better than if you're a heel striker. For me personally, when I do pick up the pace, I tend to move forward in my area where I'm landing anyway. So I do more work on the front of my foot. That's what I'm trying to say, if I can get my words out. Right, so the upper is a nice breathable mesh upper, which is awesome. The lacing's great, traditional, but as you can see, I have locked it down with a runner's knot. That's because this is a UK 9.5 and actually has come out a little bit bigger than the other shoes by 361. So I would say if you're looking for a snug fit, maybe go down half a size, but I've not had any rubbing or problems with that. And that is one of the awesome things with the 361 shoes that I have found, is that I'm able to slip them on and go straight out the door, and I've not had any issues with them. The heel area is nice. It's minimalistic, but there's a little bit of padding in there, which is great, so just enough. And what I really like is a nice minimalistic tongue on a racier shoe, sort of shaving the weight, which is great. The outsole's cool, you've got blown rubber, plenty of traction on there. As you can see, I've been wearing them down the canal towpath where I run, and there's been no problem as I've run these in the wet and the dry, and the outsole's been fantastic. How does it feel? It feels kind of nice, actually. It pops along. As I said, the more you get onto your toes, the better, I would say, and then you get that sort of snap from the propulsion plate. I've been wearing these on tempo runs, fartlek, and interval sessions. And what I have found is that even on those tempo runs where I wanted to go over, my tempo runs tend to be around 5 to 7 kilometers. But if I wanted to stretch the run out to say like a 10K, if I'm feeling okay, this has been fantastic. And it's felt great, yeah, at speed. And it's felt great at lower speed as well. I actually wore these on a recovery run the other day, basically because they were down at the bottom of the stairs and I couldn't be bothered to go and get another pair. So I stuck these on for a recovery run and they just did a perfect job. Nice and light, as I said, and that was fantastic for me. So I think if you're looking for something different, which I think is awesome about 361, is they are different. They are making good shoes. They're well made. As I said, it's a great breathable upper. And I think actually, this upper on this shoe is probably more breathable than the other shoes, and there's nothing wrong with the other uppers on the Spire 4 and the Meraki, but this just seems to be ultra breathable. But yeah, if you're looking for something a little bit different, breathable, lightweight, an up-tempo shoe, check it out. The Pacer ST, so you've got that propulsion plate in there, so it's giving you that little bit of snap. It's definitely worth checking out, guys, especially nowadays where we're doing like training blocks and everybody's getting into these like sort of speed sessions and doing different sorts of runs. If you're looking for a shoe specifically for those up-tempo runs, have a look at the Pacer ST.